It's one of those horrible one of those horrible illnesses that, although it's, it may be so hard on everyone around her, she seems to have, she doesn't seem to have suffered, Mum doesn't seem to have suffered too much going into it personally herself. It seems everyone else around her kind of has a great deal, but she seems to have peacefully gone into it. And, it reminds me every time I think of that one episode of West Wing where they refer to it as, the disease is referred to as the long goodbye. And it really is, because although there's no end to, it's just a continual event. Like, it's a continual suffering. Well, it feels like a continual suffering to us. Maybe not, obviously we don't know what exactly is going through, a person who's suffering Alzheimer's mind. There was a lot of walking going on. She would walk, I think, more as a form of trying to figure things out. So it was her way of stalling for time as well. And like, if she didn't understand something and she was getting confused, her best reaction is to go for a walk. That way no one can see that she's totally confused. She would stare at her keys because she didn't know which keys would go into the lock. At one point, she didn't know which keys go into the lock. So she would just stare and try all the different keys, like try and put all these keys in the door and just keep turning. But even when she had the right key, she didn't exactly know what she's supposed to do with the key in the lock. So she was confused there. And then it got to a point where she didn't even know what the keys were for. And so she'd look at the keys and she'd look at all the keys and run through all of them in her hands, but she wouldn't know what exactly they do and what exactly, they're used for, or, what they were even. Well, my love of cooking all stems from her. I learned to cook through her, or from her, I should say. So I'm trying to, I learned all traditional dishes that she learned when she was a child with her mum. So I did the same. When I was younger, I used to, sit at the counter with my mum or at the table as she was making something. And obviously at the beginning, you just watch. And then as I got older, then I was allowed to help and take part. And then I learned how to do it. And that's what I'm trying to do with my children too. And I teach them the same sort of methods and the same dishes. And hopefully they'll pass it on to their kids as well. And the tradition will carry on. That was probably the hardest thing I've ever had to do or been expected to do, because it was. It was that I was expected to make that decision. Because there was no one else really around that could. It's really hard. So it's like one of those things, you make a decision based on logic and, rational thought. It's all for her, what's best for her. And you make that decision and, you set aside emotion. Like, emotion set aside because it's probably set aside up until the point of the actual event. So moving, the day of movement, when she is moving into the facility, and you'll notice that I say facility because I have a hard time saying home because I don't think it's a home. But the physical move is probably when the emotion starts to kick in, and that's when you start to feel the most overwhelming guilt. I know that. That's the best place for her, and I know that it's helped her in a way because she is more calm, she's more relaxed, and she's more peaceful.